Good morning, students. How are you? Are you all fit and fine? Yes. So now your science, I will be continuing. Myself, Reena Srivastava, and I will be continuing your science. So as I came to know that you are studying the chapter combustion and flame. So now we will be continuing the same chapter, and now we are in the second last topic, that is flame. Okay, so students, you have observed the LPG flame in your home, in your kitchen. So any time have you observed the color of the flame? If you have not observed, now you have to observe. Okay, so the color of the LPG flame is blue, and same way there are different other colors also. So what happens that those substances, now the question arises, which substances produce flame? So what we will say, that those substances which vaporize on burning gives flame. Okay, so in your NCERT, just open your NCERT book and just see page number 70, and in page number 70 you will observe that a table is given, and in that table you can see some name of some substances are given, like it is given candle, it is given magnesium, it is given camphor, kerosene flame and charcoal, and you have to complete the table. So what you have to do is that if the substances form flames, then you have put a tick in front of it, otherwise just cross it. So you can see, so in case of candle, so what does the candle produces flame? Yes, you all have observed also. Then magnesium. In case of magnesium ribbon also, when we burn magnesium, then it forms a flame. So here also you can put the tick in front of the magnesium. Then comes the camphor. Camphors, you know, we are using in the when we are praying, that time we are using a camphor to lit in front of the God. So there also we are using, and then kerosene stove, you all have seen. Then the charcoal. So out of these five substances, all produce flame except charcoal. So when you will burn charcoal, it will not produce the flame, and you have to complete this table in your NCERT book. Now the question arises, we said we are talking about the flame, so now the question arises, what is the structure of flame? So to understand it, we should perform one activity, and in this activity what we have to do is that we will take a candle. Okay, so let's take a candle and we have to light it. So I have already lit it here, so you can see this candle. And now what we have to do, that we have to bring a 4 to 5 centimeter glass pipe in front of the non-flickering end. Non-flickering means which is not moving. There you have to bring, and then just like, suppose this is a glass tube. Actually, this is not a glass tube. This is a plastic. So I am just showing you. You have to bring it near it, and then after this, what you have to do is that you have to bring a matchstick in front of this here at the mouth, and then when you will bring a burning matchstick, this flame you can observe here also. So are you understanding? You have to take a candle and you have to just bring a pipe here, and then it is here, it is burning, and then you will bring a matchstick here. So here also you can see the same type of flame you will observe here also. So this is the activity. So now the question arises, why you can see the flame at the mouth of the glass tube? So can you answer this? Yes. So the answer is that in candle there is a wick. You have observed a wick in between. So what happens, that a wick is there and the molten wax is there. So what happens, that when this wick and molten wax vaporize, they form a flame. So this way we can say that those substances which vaporize on burning gives a flame, while those substances which do not vaporize, like charcoal. Charcoal does not vaporize. So that's why it will not show any flame, and it will be only red hot. Like you have seen coal also, when we burn coal, in the starting you can see some flame is there, but after some time, when all the substances, gaseous substances which are present in coal, it vaporizes, then only red hot coal is there. Same way here also, the reason is that because the vaporized substances are not left in the coal. So this way we can say that those substances in which the vapors are formed, which vaporize on burning, they form the flame, and those substances which do not vaporize, they do not form flame. Now, in the continuing to this, let's perform one more activity, and in that activity you will understand that in the flame there are some unburnt particles, carbon particles unburnt. So to understand it, what we have to do is that we will again take a candle and just hold it, just keep it on the table, and it should not move, it should be steady. When it becomes steady, then you have to bring a glass plate or any glass slide you can bring. So actually this is not a glass, this is a plastic, I am just showing you. So what we have to do is we have to bring it in front of it, above it, and just keep it for some time. Like this you have to keep it. So when you will keep it for some time, again you will observe. So this you can do, and when you will observe that here a black patch will be there, and this black patch will be also due to the unburnt carbon particles. Unburnt carbon particles will be there. Due to that reason you can see the patch. It means in the flame some unburnt particles are also there. Now one more activity is related to this, to understand that which is the hottest zone and which is the coldest zone. So what we have to do this for this, that we will take a copper wire. This is a copper wire, thin copper wire we have to take, and then what we have to do is again we will take the candle. Like this we have taken the candle, and then we will bring this copper. Can you see? Yes. So this copper wire, when you bring, so here you will see where you are bringing it here, and it becomes red hot. Here you can see that after here at the outermost zone it will become red hot. So keep it for some time, then it will become red hot. So here also the reason is same, that what happens in the candle, what happens that in the candle the outermost zone is the hottest zone, because when we bring the copper wire, we are bringing it in the center of the first layer of the candle. So you will see that the outermost zone will become, because it is very hot, so the copper wire will become start becoming red hot, and that red hot is due to the hotness of the outermost zone. So this way we can say that the outermost zone of the candle is the hottest zone. Now the question arises, how many zones are there in the candle? So for this we will draw the diagram of the candle flame, and then we can understand about it. Okay, so let's continue and let's draw the structure of the candle flame. You can open your NCERT book, and in that NCERT book you can see the structure of the flame. Okay, so now let's draw a candle, and in that you can see the structure of the flame. So students, here you can see the different zones of the candle. This is the structure of the candle. Okay, so in this, if you will carefully observe, you will see three zones are there. You see outermost zone, this is the outermost zone, and outermost zone is of complete combustion, means whatever substances are there, comes there, they are completely burnt. Okay, so and here complete combustion takes place. One more reason is there, that the availability of oxygen, the oxygen is present in more amount in the complete combustion zone, because complete combustion will take place only in the presence of oxygen. Okay, now the if you will observe the color of the candle, you will see that its color is blue. So here the outermost zone is of blue color and it is of complete combustion and it is the hottest zone. As you can see that when we were doing the activity of copper wire, the copper wire becomes red hot in the outermost zone because of the hotness of this zone. Now the second zone, you can see here, this is the middle zone, and in this middle zone that partial combustion takes place. Partial combustion means that in this case the oxygen supply is less, little bit less, so that's why complete combustion does not take place in this zone. And this is of yellow color and it is moderately hot, means it is less hot than the first zone. Now comes the innermost zone, and this innermost zone of the unburnt wax is there and it is of black color, and this black color is there and it is the least hot zone. Here the hotness is very very less. So this is the structure of the different zones of the candle, and you know this is one of the important question for your exam. It will 100% come in your exam, so just practice it 2-3 times, draw it in your notebook and practice it in your rough notebook 2-3 times. So let's summarize that what is the structure of the candle flame once again. So here you can see there are 3 parts: outermost, middle zone and the innermost zone. Outermost zone is of blue color, middle zone is of yellow color and innermost zone is of black color. This is the hottest part, this is moderately hot and this is least hot. Okay, so now students, what happens, you know the use of this hottest zone. This hottest zone is used by the goldsmith, and in this what they are doing, that when they bring the blowpipe, they have a blowpipe and they are using that blowpipe for melting gold and silver. And like suppose this is a blowpipe and this is the candle, just this is the candle, and in this candle let me show you how they are doing. So here you can see, suppose this is the blowpipe and this is the candle. So what they are doing, from here like this they are blowing air, and here at this place they are keeping the gold or silver, and then when they are blowing, and then when they are blowing, they bring it near the outermost zone. This is the hottest zone. So here you can see this is the outermost zone, and this outermost zone is of blue color. So here when they bring it, it is as it is hottest, the gold melts and they can give the desired shape. Whatever shape they require, they can give the shape for the gold and silver ornaments. So this is the structure of the candle flame. From here also you can once again you can observe. If you will carefully observe, here you see, carefully observe, you will see blue color is outside and this blue color is very light, so it is not very clearly visible. So this is the blue zone. And then after that you see yellow color is more there. Why it is more there? Because yellow color is more visible than the blue color, and it takes the wider area. So yellow zone is more. And if carefully observe, you can lit a candle at home and clearly carefully observe, you will see in between some black zone is visible, and that is the innermost zone. So this way, this is the structure of the candle, different zones of the candle flame. So this is all about the candle and its different zones. So students, let's summarize what we studied today. So first of all, we studied what is a flame, then what is the color of the flame. We studied about the color of the flame, that the color of the flame, you can, from here you can see that it is of 3 colors. The outermost is of blue color, then innermost is of black color, and the in between there is a yellow color. Then Sometimes you might have observed that sometimes reddish color you may have seen in your LPG gas also. At last, when the gas is going to be finished, sometimes the reddish color is there. You know why that reddish color is there? That reddish color is because of some impurities which are present in the LPG cylinder. Okay. Otherwise or normally it is of blue color, and it is the hottest. Because it is hottest, so it is of blue color. So this is all about the different zones, and we studied different activities. And now you should remember that both the questions are very important, that what is the structure of the different zones of the candle, then the why does the goldsmith blow the outermost zone of a candle flame with a metallic blowpipe for melting gold and silver. This is also one of the question, and it can come in give reasons. So today you just revise this, you just read the NCERT book, and as well as you just go through the activities, you will be able to understand clearly. And in the next turn we will study about fuels.